Hello, everybody, and thank you so much for tuning in to tonight's episode of What is in the Night Sky this month, November edition. I am Teagan with High Point, and I will be taking you on a beautiful tour of the night sky in the month of November. We will be traveling past our solar system and taking a look at several deep sky objects such as star clusters and other galaxies. We're going to take a look at the moon and the planets as well, and we're also going to talk about a celestial event occurring on November 8th, a lunar eclipse. You're definitely not going to want to miss this. So as always, buckle in and let's see what's really out there. Now, 2022 has brought us two separate lunar eclipses. The first one was best viewed on the East Coast, and this one coming up on November 8th can be viewed by both the West and the East Coast, but you will need to be up pretty early to experience it. The eclipse starts at 3:02 in the morning Eastern Time, and totality begins at 5:16 Eastern Time. By the time the partial phase begins, the moon will be fairly low over the western horizon for East Coast observers. Totality begins shortly before the start of astronomical dawn for observers on the east. This leaves little time to enjoy the moon and the lunar eclipse in totality. While the eclipse for those on the East Coast may be low on the horizon, this presents an awesome opportunity for some beautiful photographs, maybe through the trees or over a nice cityscape. Now for our next object, we're going to move out past the moon a ways and actually past our galaxy, and we're going to take a look at an object that lies 2.8 million light years away, Messier 31, otherwise known as the Andromeda Galaxy. Messier 31 has been known since ancient times. The Andromeda Galaxy is the furthest object that you can see with your naked eye. Nowadays, you will need to be under dark skies if you want to have any chance of seeing it without an eyepiece. It's more easily seen with binoculars or a small telescope, and it will appear as a narrow, ghostly gray misty patch. Any telescope with a low magnification will show the galaxy's bright core, and if you look carefully, you should be able to spot its two satellite galaxies, Messier 32 and Messier 101. Next on our list is a deep sky object that lies just below Andromeda, and it's known as the Double Cluster, also a beautiful sight under dark skies with your naked eye. As with the Andromeda Galaxy, the Double Cluster has been known since antiquity. They're both relatively large open clusters, and consequently, they're best observed with binoculars or a telescope with a low power wide angle eyepiece. This is a favorite among many amateur astronomers around the world, and you simply can't go wrong with the Double Cluster. Use anything more than about 75 times magnification, and you may have difficulty fitting them both within the same field of view. NGC 869 is the more westerly of the pair and is more concentrated, while NGC 884 holds a number of coppery stars within its grasp. From the Double Cluster, we travel towards another beautiful open cluster known as the Owl Cluster. There are few star clusters that so obviously resemble the object they're named for, but the Owl Cluster is one of them. Like the Double Cluster, the Owl is a favorite among amateur astronomers, and it really allows your imagination to run wild. Other names include the Dragonfly Cluster or even the ET Cluster. The eyes of the Owl are represented by the double star Phi Cassiopeia. Most of this cluster is fairly sparse, with the largest concentration of stars appearing in the Owl's chest area. Now, before we see what the moon and the planets are up to this month, there is one more deep sky object on our list, but it's not a star cluster, nor is it a galaxy, but rather a double star. Gamma Arietis is a pair of bright white stars of equal brightness. Split with a small telescope at low power, this is best seen at a magnification of around 100 times. This is a showpiece double star for the fall and is readily accessible to almost anybody with a telescope. Visually, they're reminiscent of tiny diamonds on black satin, and it's worth remembering that this is a true multiple star system. Each star is roughly 34 million years old and nearly three times more massive than our own sun. Now it is time to bring the tour back within our own solar system. Let's see what the moon and the planets are up to this month. Neither Mercury nor Venus are visible this month, but Saturn can still be enjoyed for a few hours after sunset. You'll find it above the southwest horizon with a first quarter moon nearby on the 1st, and you can find it with a waxing crescent moon close by on November 28th. Telescopic observers can also observe Neptune, while Jupiter continues to shine brightly just a little ways towards the east of the planet. You'll find a waxing gibbous moon to the left of Jupiter on November 4th. As for Uranus, it reaches opposition in Aries on November 9th. This gives you the best opportunity to spot this ice giant this year. Mars, now in retrograde in neighboring Taurus, it reaches opposition next month, but the red planet is already an outstanding telescopic sight. It is well worth investing some time at the eyepiece to make the most of it. You'll find it midway between the horns of the bull and the waning gibbous moon to its upper right during the evening of November 10th. And as for the moon, it is full on November 8th, and then it turns new on the 23rd. Okay, so that is it for our tour of the night sky in the month of November. We thank you so much for staying tuned. If you like this video, please be sure to like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel so you don't miss any future content. Also, please be sure to tune in on November 8th as we are doing a live stream of the lunar eclipse. Our very own Kyle will be commentating the event as he presents the live view of the lunar eclipse through one of his telescopes. Now, that being said, we hope you have a wonderful night and clear skies.